So today topic we will be covering about eye rolls, like what is eye roll and how we implement eye roll practical, and some use cases of eye roll. So eye roll was introduced in version 10, 11, 12. Every version has eye roll. And there is one another concept which has been introduced now is local traffic policy. So it is an advanced version of eye rule only. Only difference is it has inbuilt events. I will show you what is the difference between local traffic policy versus eye rule. So let's start with practical use cases and what is eye rule. So basically, eye rule is just a feature. We can say it's a feature which has been introduced by Big IP. So it's just a programming. You can say it's a language where you can extend your Big IP functionality. How you can extend the Big IP functionality is, like, suppose there is some big functionality which cannot be implemented by Big IP architecture. I will show you like how, what are the features which has been introduced by eye rules which are not being introduced directly. So you can say it's just a powerful feature. The features which cannot be implemented by Big IP, inbuilt features can be implemented by eye rule. So eye rule, you can say it's a scripting language. So when we go forward, you will come to know like what is eye rules and how it is. So basically eye rule is a scripting language. It's easy to learn. So what this does do? So it will help us to inspect the traffic, modify the traffic behavior. So these are very important terms. So eye rule will help you to intercept. So intercept means some traffic is coming, I need to modify and send to the pool member. And inspect, so this is the important term. And direct or redirect the traffic. So eye rule will help you which cover this topic. So it will direct traffic according to the behavior of your application. So this is very important concept of eye rule. You need to understand like what is eye rule. So eye rule, you can say it's a programming or a scripting language which helps you to add functionality that is not built in Big IP, and it will allow you to inspect, redirect or direct or modification of traffic behavior. So this is very, very important, like what is eye rule and how it intercept. So let's come forward on what are the tasks which are can be done by eye rules. So I prepared this. So basically, let's say we have a requirement to block specific clients. Let's say I have F5. In my picture, I have server 1, server 2, and this both are part of pool 1, let's say. And I have multiple clients, which is US client. I have client in Australia. And I have client in Bangladesh. So by default, there is no functionality in LTM. Let's say I have a requirement. I have a requirement that I don't want my Bangladesh traffic to access this application. Let's say it's a web Apache app application. I want to block this application from Bangladesh. So can I do via default feature of LTM? Is there any functionality in LTM of geolocation? Can I block anything on based on geolocation? No, I cannot. So that's why iRule has come in picture. So iRule will help you to detect where the traffic is coming. Either it's coming from Bangladesh, either it's coming from India, Australia, and it will block. So it means I can access application web Apache from US. I can access web application from Australia, but I cannot do it from Bangladesh. So this is what the definition is. It will manipulate the traffic and modify it. So that is one of the advantage and use case of iRule. Next one, let's talk about more use cases. I want to turn SNAT, like we had talked about SNAT and NAT. What I want is, like, for particular clients, I don't want SNAT to be turned on. For particular clients, I want it to be turned on. This can be implemented by iRules. I want to select different pool based on my client request. Let's say I have client Mozilla. I have client Google Chrome, who are using Google Chrome. I have F5, which is coming in picture. And I have one pool, one, let's say. And I have another pool, let's say pool two. So I want my all Mozilla based traffic goes to pool one. And I want all my Google Chrome traffic goes to pool two. So this can be done based on iRule. So people have a requirement. Can my VS can use multiple pools? Guys, this is the question which people ask. Can my VS, my virtual server, let's say I have client, I have F5, and I have pool one, pool two. Can I call in my URL, which is called virtual server, can I call multiple pools by default? No, I cannot call multiple pools by default in my URL. So how I can implement, like, Mozilla traffic should go to pool one, Google Chrome traffic should go to pool two. So that can be done by iRule. So this way you will get to know more about iRule. Let's say I have a feature which is called, I want some traffic to redirect client to different website. I have some application. Let's say I have my customer only wants to access HTTPS. He should not see HTTP. Customer only wants to access HTTPS based website. I need to force them. But customer do not know what is HTTP. Or what is HTTPS. So customer will go to the browser and he will just type the IP address of the URL. Or let's say he will just type www.cianets.com. He will just access this cianets.com. So in this case, he do not know what is HTTP, what is HTTPS. So I want to redirect every traffic of client to HTTPS. Whether he types HTTP or he types only the website, I only want them to redirect to HTTPS. So that is another advantage of iRule. So all this can be done by iRule. Let's say another use case, I want to inspect and modify my server response. Let's say I have client, I have F5, and I have server one. So this is all based on your HTTP request. Your server is received the traffic from F5. Now, server is sending some response. Let's say server has an application, www.cianets.com. sianets.com. But customer is accessing www.google.com. So what happened is F5 can also modify the response and redirect the traffic to the client. I want something to be hidden. Like I don't want your server pool name in my client. I only want to inspect and modify the server response. That can also be done. Let's say I have a client and I have F5 and I have server one. Server one has sent some ABC as a text on response, but client should receive DEF. So that can also be done based on your iRule. That is called stream profile in iRule, which can replace particular pattern from F5. That can also be done by iRule. This is very important. It can inspect and modify your server response. There is one more requirement which generally comes. Let's say I have an application sianets.com, which has gone to the maintenance page. For some time, there is maintenance going on. I don't want my client says that URL is not accessible. He should see that there is some maintenance going on. So I can set it through iRule. When customer access sianets.com, he can see that there is a maintenance going on. So that can be done by iRule. So that is very, very important. Sometimes I do not want to, I don't want URL not accessible page. I just want my maintenance page. So that can be done by iRule. Every feature which is not inbuilt by BigIP can be done by iRule. It's very interesting topic. When you go to the production environment, you will see multiple use cases. So these are the common tasks which is done by iRule. Let's say, when should iRule should not be used? So that is very, very important. When there is inbuilt feature in BigIP introduced, we should not use iRule because it uses CPU and RAM when multiple events get executed. Let's say right now this is feature introduced X forwarder. What does X forwarder do? X forwarder will help your server to track client IP address. That is inbuilt feature. For that, you should not use iRule. iRule should only be used when there is a feature which is not built into BigIP. Another feature is iRule can select a pool based on HTTP host header. Now, this has been introduced by local traffic policy. So once I come across local traffic policy versus iRule, I will show you. So this is when iRule should not be used. So these are the some precautions which you can take. So this is saying this. Now let's move forward on working with iRules. So generally when we talk about iRules, so the BigIP GUI, when you log in into GUI, you will see iRule. By default, there are some iRules which are already presented. And there is already an iRule editor which will help you to implement and practice your iRule programming. So you can go to local traffic, iRules, and you can edit and create. So I will show you like how we can create iRules. So you just need to go to local traffic. Then there is a concept iRules where you can create and edit your iRules according to your requirements. So I will show you that in coming pictorial representation. So see, this is how you will see I rule. So I will cover this, what is when and what is event. So it is coming in soon, but this is how it looks like. You need to give the name of I rule to represent it, like what is I rule representing. Then here you don't need to execute your code. That's it. Once it's done, you need to finish it. That is how you create your I rule. So just you need to go to local traffic, I rules, and you will see this features. Now let's move forward on what does I rule generally contains. And once you have created your I rule, you can just associate with your virtual server. So you need to go to local traffic, virtual server, and you need to go to the resources tab, where you will see the manage tab. Here you need to just call your I rule. Because client will hit your traffic on virtual server, right? He does not know whether I rule is there or I rule is not there. So you need to tell them, you need to associate with virtual server. So you need to go to local traffic, virtual server, and you need to go to resources tab, where you will need to call your I rule. So this can be done this way. So now let's talk, this is very, very important. Let's talk about how I rule works. So I rule use your TCL language. TCL language is called tool command language. We have Python, .NET, everything. But in here in F5, I rule generally uses your TCL language. That will offer you possibility of examine and altering your traffic. So by default, I rule is using your TCL language. So people have questions like, what does I rule use? So I rule is a scripting language which uses tool command language, which will examine and alter your traffic. Now let's talk about what is event and what is condition. So guys, for I rule, generally we have syntax. So we have when condition, and then we have if condition, and this is where I need to give the pool or what action I need to perform. So let's talk about more into details, like what is I rule components. So I rule components, I will show you what does it contains. So you need to just use this. Whenever you use any I rule, you need to use first condition, which is called when. Then if this condition, then what action. So this is three components I rule contains. I rule contains three components. Whenever you create anything, there are three components which I rule contain. First, when you want a specific event to be occurred. Second, if the condition is true, which is this. This is first condition, this is second. Third is, if condition is true, then perform the specific action. That is how it works. This is I rule components, which is very, very important. Three components will create your I rules. So first of all, you need to understand what is event. Like we have talked about I rules. Now let's talk about what are events. What is this event? You have talked about syntax, okay. Now let's talk further on what is events, what is if condition, and what is the action when condition is true. So let's go further. So these are all called events. What are events? Events are basically used to trigger, or it can be say it's a driver to execute rule. So I am driving a car. I will start a car. So that is my event. So suppose let's say I have a car. What is my event in the car? Let's say I have driving a car. What is event in my car? First, I need to start. So I need to tell them, I need to trigger some command, right? So that car knows that I need to start it. So that is called event. So events can be multiple. So event is generally a trigger or driver to execute your I rules. So I rules are event driven. It works based on your event. So let's say we have multiple events. Can you see this? We have one event client accepted, one event HTTP request, one event as LB selected, one event as server connected, and one event as HTTP response. So let's say we talk about first event is client accepted. What does it mean? So this event will be used. This event will be initiated when an IP connection is accepted. And established. So it means three-way handshake has been done. So that event will be triggered. When does this HTTP request? By wording only, it is there. When HTTP underscore request. Let's say I want to redirect all traffic coming on HTTP to HTTPS. So what is the event you need to call here? How F5 will know that all traffic which is coming to HTTP, I redirect to HTTPS. That is called HTTP underscore request. It means when a client, it will be initiated when a client HTTP request is received. Are you getting me? Because you are using HTTP, right? You will be typing HTTP colon cnets.com. So what is the event here? So HTTP request is an event because I am triggering based on my HTTP request. So this is called another event. So that is what we have to call, right? First condition is when condition, when the event should trigger. So that is called event. So first you need to call event trigger. So event trigger can be either client accepted. So client accepted are basically works on your layer 4. But if you need to trigger some event based on layer 7, then you need to receive used HTTP request and HTTP response. So this is all been called here. So how BigIP will know what is request and what is response and how it will track? It is based on your events. So I rules are event driven. So in order to start processing the data, events are used. So events are helpful to start. You can say, if someone asks you, you can say events are the process to start processing of data. Once it matches an event. So event can be your client side event. Event can be your server side. So we can also say when HTTP underscore response. This is also one event, which means I need to modify what is received from the server and I need to send to the client. So in this case, you need to configure iRule in this way. There are other condition which is called LB selected and LB failed. So LB selected would be done when सिस्टम वांट्स टू सिलेक्ट अ पूल मेंबर. सो देयर आर मेनी इवेंट्स विच कैन बी डन, बट यू नीड टू नो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज इवेंट, व्हाट इज HTTP underscore request, व्हाट इज HTTP रेस्पॉन्स. सो दिस ऑल कम्स योर अंडर योर आई रूल. सो इवेंट कैन बी एनी थिंग बेस्ड ऑन योर क्लाइंट साइड इवेंट और बेस्ड ऑन योर सर्वर साइड इवेंट. सो विच इज ऑलवेज कॉल्ड अंडर वेन कंडीशन. दिस इज द फर्स्ट कंडीशन. Now let's talk about other components of iRule. This was your first component. Now let me go. So this is how iRule HTTP events occurred. You don't need to know much on this, but here that is. So let's say I am using event when client accepted. So it will be based on your layer 4. We can see HTTP request. Then we can see HTTP response. I need to redirect some traffic based on HTTP response and send to the client. So that is how events triggered. It's just a formula. So it's just an event order, which you can say, iRule events. When some event should trigger and when should not it occur. So that is called iRule event order. So it's just a pictorial representation. So now let's talk about iRule. So I have to implement an iRule based on my browser. So I want to redirect traffic based on browser. So first, can you see this? I need to give iRule name. Then can you see this when condition? When, because it's based on your browser. So browser is based on your HTTP request, because browser details will only come on HTTP request. Then we have condition. So generally conditions are based on your if and else. So first one I have given rule. Second one I have given event. And third one is your conditional statement. This is called your conditional statement, which says if my user agent contains Internet Explorer, it should go to Internet Explorer pool. But if my user agent contains Mozilla, it should go to Mozilla pool. Else, it can go to any pool. So this is as simple as that. So you just need to understand three components. First one is you need to give rule name. Second one, you need to give event. Third one, you need to give the conditional statement. And if this is true, then this will execute. If this is not true, it will go to this. And if this it is not true, it will go to this. So it's a simple if else condition. So you are giving, if this condition is true, it should execute this action. If this is not true, it should go to next else if. Else it should go to this. So this is how your iRule event works. So if I do this, I'm just using this. First, I'm giving rule, then rule name, then my bracelet, then I'm giving when condition, and I'm giving event, then one start is there. This is to start event. So you need to take care of this bracelets. So this bracelet should close here. This when should close here. This if should close here. You need to take care of these things. This is simple programming language. Then you need to give if conditional statement. So you need to give conditional statement. Then you need to give action when condition is true. That is all you need to take care of. That's all. That is your how your I rule works. Let's say I have another use case of I rule, which means it should works on based on layer 4. I don't want layer 7 traffic to modify or examining. I only want my layer 4 traffic. So what would be the event? Event will be only because I'm using, I should say that if my report address starts with 10, it should go to my SIA pool. If my remote address does not start with this, it should go to another pool. So this is how it goes. So I'm giving event because I'm not using anything based on my HTTP header. So that is called another example or use case. So this is based on your events. So let me open one more thing where I will tell you something more on what are operators. So we have talked so far about I rule events, but we can use also operators. So I rules can use with combination of your operators. So we have one operator called OR operator, one operator called AND operator, and one operator called as NOT operator. So it's just a programming language if you're using Python or something. So basically it can be used with it. Like we can use HTTP event based on AND. Like I want to say that if my browser contains Mozilla and my client IP starts with 10 network. So what does AND means? If this both conditions are true, then only perform particular action. So it is called operator operation. So AND means both the conditions should be true, OR means if your browser is Mozilla but your client IP is not starting with 10, but your one condition is true, so it will send the traffic to that pool member based on your input. So that is called I rule operator. So if I talk about like how I can implement this, so I will talk more on, let's go practically and let's perform one of the labs where I will show you like how to implement I rule. So I will log in to the admin. So first of all, you need to go to local traffic and you need to perform I rule section. So what I will do is I will go to local traffic and here it is. So by default, you will see some of I rules already built. So you can just open it. This is F5 already been used. F5 has already been called. So can you see this? There is when condition, first condition, this is called event. Then these are conditional statement, which is second component. And then there is third component, which is called action. So you can implement multiple if and else also. Multiple if and else can also be used with I rule. Also, you can use I rules. Let's say I want to use I rule. Is it like people have question? Is it necessary to use if else? No. So another question people ask is, let's say I want to redirect 192.168.1.0/24 to my pool, SIA pool. So what I will do is, you tell me. So I will use when client accepted. This is my event. Then I will start my bracelet. Then I will say if my IP address. This all will, I will show you. This is easy. Events, this will automatically come. So I will say IP address. Then I will give IP client address, ADDR. If it equals my 192.168.1.6, it should go to pool, SIA underscore pool. This is the pool member. Then I will cross the bracket. So you can only use if also. If you have only one pool, you can just select based on if. Else would only come when this condition is not true. Else if there are three conditions, right? You can see when you go to iRule, you can see we have if condition, then we have else condition. So we can use if this is not true, then it should go to else. But suppose I need to implement multiple if else, then you can use if, then else if, then else. So this is how it goes, how if else condition your conditional statements goes on. So this is how your iRules work. Let's implement one of the iRule. I'm implementing one of the iRule where what I want is, I want all my HTTP request, which is coming to my virtual IP, which is 192.196.160. It should redirect to HTTPS. So how I can implement using iRule? So what I will do is, I will delete this. First of all, I will go to iRule. So there are two use cases of this. First one, you should have two virtual servers. One virtual server with port 80. One virtual server, this is a pre-request with port 443. So this is one of the occasion when I want to redirect all my HTTP request, which is coming on 80 to port 443. So in this case, what happening is your client request should always go to port 443. So what I will do is I will just create one VIP with port 80. In port 80, I will not call my pool because port 80 will only be used to redirect to port 443. So original pool members, I will call on. There is no use case of using pool on port 80 because I want all my traffic client should go to this pool member present on 443. So, but I should use port 80, right? Because initially customer will only say it should access 1.60. That's it. So that's why I need to use two VIPs. So let's see if we have two VIPs. So can you see this? I have two VIPs already created. So one with port 80. So I have 192.168.1.60 on 80. And I have another VIP, which is on 443. Now let's see where I need to call my iRule. So I will go to my port 80. So can you see this? I have port 80, but let's go to resources. So just notice this. I will be not using any pool member on port 80. Pool member is none on port 80. But here I will be using one iRule, which is called HTTP to HTTPS. But where I will be calling pool then? So I will go to virtual server, go to HTTPS. So can you see this? Here I will be calling my, so pool will be called on 443. Because my client request will always come to 443 FIP. So this was the pre-request which I need to tell you. So let me create an I rule and then we will call. So what I will do is I will go to resources and I have created one I rule. So what I will give is I will create this I rule again. Let me create from scratch so that you will understand the syntax and all of this. So what I will do is I will delete this and I will create one I rule, new one. What I will do is I will go to I rule, local traffic, then I will go here. So I will be giving I rule name. I rule name is HTTP to HTTPS and it's called CS. You can give any name which can represent it. Now here I will give condition. So can you see this? When I give when, it's already giving me when. So what I will do, I will just press H, then HTTP. It will give everything here. So see, it's giving me all events related to available on HTTP. So can you see this? By default, I'm getting when HTTP request. You don't need to know any programming language. Just I will do this. Then I will open bracelet. What I will do is now when HTTP request, what I should good? I should type HTTP. It's all what you need to give. It's already given. I need to redirect it. So I will see one redirect. That's it. Then I will just put where I need to redirect. HTTPS 192.168.16.60. That's it. And you need to just close it. So this is how you need to call your I rule. So everything, whenever type and I'm typing something, it's giving me, let's say when HTTP, let's say when client. So can you see this? It's already given me events. So you don't need to remember what need to call. You just need to understand your requirements from application team. Then I rule will help you. So I have just created to redirect all requests which will come from this to HTTPS. I will just finish it. See, I wanted to show you this error. Why this error is, let's say, what it's saying? It's saying that unknown event HTTP request. So there seems to be some error. You can just need to take care of gaps also. Again, it's giving error. So what I will do is, so you need to take care of this brackets. So when you click here, can you see this? It should have some broad mark. So I click here, it will give me that it requires a bracket. Let me give one more bracket. So can you see this bracket has a closer here. It will be marked with this. When I click this, it will be showing like this. This, but this is extra. So what I will do is I will just finish it. So now I have created. So syntax also, it will correct. It will give you error. So there is no outage. So people have question, like when I use any I rule, until in production environment, people have caution. Like can I create I rule without raising any changes? Yes, you can raise n number of, you can test it, you can raise it, you can use n number of I rules. But when it causes outage, until I rule is not called, on virtual server, it won't create any outage. That thing you need to understand. You can create n number of IRLs from here until you called on virtual server, it won't detect any traffic. So that's one I wanted to tell you. So I've created one IRL, which you can see here. So you, let's say this one, this was for my IRL. So I need to call this IRL on my virtual server. So I will go to virtual server. I will go to port 80 because I need to redirect every traffic of port 80 to port 443. So what I will do, I will click on manage. And here, whatever you have created from available tab. So available tab means all this you can call on your virtual server. So let's say I'm deleting this. I will just select this and I will select this. So enabled means it will be getting enabled. So what I'm doing is I want to implement all my HTTP traffic redirect to HTTPS. So this is how it will do. So let's test it. Let me go to the browser and I will test it. I will go to Ignoto mode. What I'm doing, I don't know what is HTTP or HTTPS. So I will just type 192.168.160. I'm just accessing it. It's giving me some error. Let's see what is the error it's giving. So I have 443. I have pool of 3. It's giving me some error. Let me see why. I will go to 443. Actually, I have enabled SNAT, so I just need to SNAT automap here because my server default gateway was not F5, so I just enabled automap. Let's see if it's accessible now. So see, so can you see this? It has already migrated to redirect my traffic to HTTPS. It's not showing, not secure because I'm using self-signed certificate. But can you see this? Here, it's giving me HTTPS. In the front of the browser, it's showing me HTTPS. Here, see this, HTTPS. It has redirected. I just type this, and can you see this? To see if it has redirected, just click here and see the protocol. So it is happening. And it's giving me not secure. Why? Because it's issued by my cnets.com, which is not trusted. So I typed HTTP and it's redirecting. Let me remove it, okay? Let's remove IRL from this. Let's see if it works or not. So my question is, guys, I have removed HTTP in IRL. Will it work if I type HTTP? Let's say I will just type 192.168.1.60. Will it, should it work or not? Right now it's redirecting. Let's see why it's redirecting. Because there is no IRL here. It's still redirecting. Let me, I've cleared everything. HTTPS. Okay. Just using. So generally it should not work. Let me close this and let me access from here. HTTP. I should not type HTTP, just this. So see, because that was taking from cache, so that's why it was working, but now it's not working. But if I type HTTPS 192.168, will it work? See, it's working because I need manually defining it. But if I type 192.168.1.60, it's giving this site cannot be reachable. Now what I will do is I will again call on my virtual server resources, and I will go to manage tab, and I will just call my iRule here. So let's see. See, now I typed this only and it's working. How to check whether iRule is working fine? You need to go to iRule particular. Sometimes there is an issue, like sometimes iRule is not working. How to check strats? So you should go to iRule and then you should go to particular iRule name. Then you need to close strats. This is very, very important point based on your troubleshooting. So you need to see what is execution. Are you getting any failures? So this will tell you if iRule is working fine or not. I've executed it. This is my event type and execution is successful. I'm not getting any failure. So if zero failure means this iRule has successfully executed. So this is helpful in troubleshooting. Sometimes customer will say, hey, URL is not accessible. I'm accessing URL. My VIP is up. My pool member is up. So what can be issue? So one issue can be your iRule is not implemented successfully. Correct. I have shown you that scenario when you were accessing your virtual servers were up. Your pool members were up. But still your page was saying URL not accessible. So one troubleshooting steps can be you need to check if there is any iRule defined or not. This is the use case which you need to take care of. This is very, very important. iRule can be called. Can be one major case of URL not accessible. So you need to tell them that, hey, I have checked everything. So it can be issue on this. So that is how you called your iRule. So now my caution, people have caution, like what is difference between iRule versus local traffic policy? So in 12 version, local traffic policy has been introduced, which is going to be a replacement for iRule. So let's see what is local traffic policy. So generally, basically iRule is also there, and the same functions can be done on your policy. So local traffic policy, you can use your local traffic or big IP policy also to redirect or modify your traffic. Only difference which F5 says that local traffic policy uses less CPU cycle. So it saves your resources more. That is only advantage of local traffic policy. So they have not mentioned like how it saves your CPU cycle. But if someone asks you, you need to tell them that local traffic policy saves your CPU cycle. So let's say where I can see the iRule policy, or you can say local traffic policy. So you need to go to local traffic. Can you say this policy? So you will go to create. So you need to give policy name, let's say HTTP to HTTPS. cianets.com. You can say description. So you can now execute strategy. So here you need to create your policy. You need to call rule. So I will give HTTPS redirect. Now you need to give, so can you say this? Here you don't need to call anything, when, if, else. So you need to just say when HTTP event, let's say HTTP user agent. Let's say I want user agent. If Mozilla traffic comes, it should go to Mozilla pool. So what I will do? If I say Mozilla, if my browser type is Mozilla, I will add this. What should happen? I will forward traffic to pool here. So can you say this? If my user agent is Mozilla, it should go to pool 3, which is Mozilla pool. Let's create two pools. I am creating one pool more. Let's say, which is called Mozilla pool. And I'm just giving TCP. What I will do is, I'm creating one pool with address 10.2.30. Simple. So I will tell you, by default, can you go to virtual server? Can you see this? In resources tab, you can call only one pool, either Mozilla pool or pool. So people have question, like how can I use multiple pools? Can I use multiple pools on my virtual server? So people have this question. So you can use either local traffic policy, or you can use iRule. So this is the solution. So what I will do is, I am showing you policies. So what I did was, I am creating rule. So I say, if my browser agent, HTTP user agent, you don't need any programming. See, everything is coming here. And you just need to add Mozilla. Add, when this condition is true, do the following. See, do the following when the traffic is matching. So I will just forward traffic to my pool, Mozilla pool. And I will save it. Rule name is required, Mozilla redirection. So I will save this. So can you see this? Now I will create one more rule, which I will say Google Chrome redirection. What I will do is, if my user agent is Google Chrome, you can just say, if my browser type is or begins with, there are multiple operators, if contains Google Chrome, you can also use this. I should forward traffic to pool of 3. So see, this is one of the policy which I have created. So you don't need any programming syntax also here. It's automatically available. So that's why local traffic policy is also important. You don't need any programming language. People have questions like iRule is very difficult. Sometimes I need to implement hard rules. So I don't know what is the syntax. So in this case, you can use F5 has introduced local traffic policy, where you need to just call your policy name, you have strategy, and you can call one policy कैन कंटेन मल्टीपल रूल्स. सो वंस आई हैव डन दिस आई विल डिलीट दिस एंड आई विल जस्ट सेव एंड पब्लिश पॉलिसी. So now what I will do is how to call policy on my virtual server. I will go here on my virtual server, resources. So can you see this? There is one iRule tab and there is one policy tab. So I will go to policies and I will click manage. So can you see this? I will just create policy. So guys, now here is an important concept. I have a virtual server with iRules and policy. Now here the question comes. I have a virtual server with iRules. I have a virtual server with policies also. Now question comes, which will execute first. This is an important question which has been asked by interviewers. So in this case, you need to tell them whenever traffic is processed, policy will execute first. Then iRule comes. This is very, very important term. So see here, I have a virtual server with iRule and policy. So policies would be executed first, then iRule. So precedence will only happen when local traffic policies and iRules are using. So in this case, policy will be executed first. So policy will be precedence. So this is an important concept which I wanted to tell you. So policy is also a creation of your rules, and it can be associated with your conditions. You can give conditions, you can give actions. So I will delete this. There is one more question, guys. Let's say I am using one more iRule. I can implement multiple iRules in the policy. So what I can do is, now question is, I have multiple iRules in my virtual server. So which will take precedence? Which iRule will execute first? Let's not talk about policies. I'm talking about, I have two iRules here. Which will execute first? So there is a concept called iRule priority. So every iRule has a priority by default 500. Let me show you by example, by CLI. You will not see here. You need to go to PuTTY, your CLI, and you need to just run one IP address of your big IP. I will change settings. So I will just log in. So what I will do is, I will go to TMSH and I will run command list LTM rule. So I will give rule name. So here, can you see this? It's showing me the property, but it's not showing me the priority. Just give me 1 minute. What I will now do is, I will go again, TMSH. I will run list LTM rule. Then this. Then all properties. So this is also not showing. So I will go to show LTM rule. Now see, this is where your priority come. Can you see this? This is where I wanted to show you what is priority and what is CPU cycles on execution. So can you see this? All the I rules have a priority 500. If you want to execute one I rule, you need to give precedence. It will work on. You need to change your priority. And here is a CPU cycle. So I was talking about why I should implement local traffic policy because it takes less CPU execution. So you can see from here. For your confusion, if some still has confusion, let me implement I rule, which I have another I rule. Let's say I have an I rule HTTP. So can you see this? This also have a priority 500. So by default, I rules have default priority 500. So if multiple I rules are there, you can call based on your priority. So that is how your I rules and policy works. So in local traffic policy, if I tell in local traffic policy how traffic flows, let's say if I talk about local traffic policy, I'm just revising. In local traffic policy, what happens is first step is you will create draft policy. So in draft policy, you will create policy name. You will create rules. Then you will publish the policy. Because draft will only draft it. Until you publish it, it will be not seen in your virtual server. Then you need to call policy in your virtual server. So that is how you need to create your local traffic policy. So that is how it works.